Hello students, welcome to Umadevi Children Academy. Students, today we are discussing one of the important topic, that is the occurrence of the metal, right? So where the metal occurs, how the metals occurs, and the when the metal occurs in the earth crust, is it pure or impure form, and how we have to purify, all the things we are discussed today topics. So let's start the first topic, that is the topic, the occurrence of metal. Earth crust is the major source of metal. Earth crust, whatever the earth is there, the earth which contains the major source of the metal. Major source of metal is present, like the iron, copper, gold, etc. Hey, beta. Okay. Next, the sea water also contains some metal, like sodium chloride, in which sodium is metal. Magnesium chloride, in which magnesium metal, and some other water, the mineral salts are present, the mineral salt in which the metal is present here. Right, friends? Okay. So most of the metal is a quite reactive. Why it is reactive? Because they do not occurs in free state. Fresh element, the iron cannot be occurs in a Fe form in the earth crust. Sodium cannot be occurs Na form in the earth crust. Magnesium cannot be occurs Mg in the earth crust. So they are most reactive. They cannot be occur free state. Rather than they always exist in Na2O, Fe2O3, NaCl, Na2CO3. There is the sodium is a metal combined with chlorine. Sodium metal combined with carbonate. Right, students? So it means the all the metals, they cannot be exist in a free state, like they cannot be exist in this form. They always exist either this form or this form. Right, students? If I will tell you what is free metals, the free metal and combined metal. Free metal means sodium here, this form. Combined means either it is NaCl or Na2O, right? Similarly, iron. The iron cannot be exist in this free state. Rather than it exists in the earth crust as a Fe3O4 or Fe2O3, in this form it exists here. Restaurants. So this is the free state means this form. Combined state means either it is combined with some other species, oxygen, chlorine, hydrogen, etc. So most of the metal present in a combined form. The combined form. Restaurants. So example I give, the most of the metal combined with oxide form metal oxide, Na2O, Fe3O4, etc. So most of the metal combined state with carbonate to form metal carbonate, like Na2CO3, MgCO3, etc. Most of the metal combined with chloride to form metal chloride, NaCl, FeCl3, etc. Right, students? So these all are combined state. Right? Okay, look at here. I will give an example. Metal Fe. Fe with chlorine. Fe with oxygen. Fe with carbonate. Fe cannot be exist this form. Rather than in the earth crust, it is available as a FeCl3, Fe2O3, FeCO3. Restaurants. Similarly, sodium cannot be exist in a Na form. Rather than it exists in the earth crust or in a seawater as a NaCl, Na2O, Na2CO3. And Mg cannot be exist in Mg form. Rather than it exists MgCl2, MgO, MgCO3. It means the metal cannot be exist in free state. Rather than they exist in this form. Restaurants. Understood? So these are chloride groups. This is oxygen group. This is carbonate group. Right? And this is iron, sodium, magnesium. Restaurants. Only few less reactive metal, silver, gold, platinum, are found in free state. In the atmosphere, only these three elements which are exist in the free state. Free state means they are available as a Ag, silver, gold, platinum exist in free state. It cannot combine with the oxygen, carbonate, sulfide, etc. Restaurants. So metals are found in free state called as a native state. Metals are found in free state called as the native state. Right. So let's start the next. Minerals. What is minerals? Natural material in which metal or their compounds are found in the earth crust called as minerals. So when we in the soil is a natural things. So in the soil, if any metal like iron, golds are available, so such naturally available such soil we called as a minerals. We called as minerals. Right? The soil in which either gold available or the iron available or the silver available, such type of soil we called as a natural occurring soil we called as a minerals. Some minerals are contain small percentage of metal. Some minerals are contain large percentage of metal. If the large percentage of metals are present in the minerals called as a ore. It is most important, students. The important, this is the ore. So what is ore? Ore means the mineral which contain large percentage of metal called as a ore. Right? Or one more definition here. Mineral from which metals are extracted conveniently and profitably called as ore. Students, so it means, students, for example, sodium, right? So sodium available as a NaCl form, which is exist in the seawater as a 90% example, general example, right? And sodium also available as a Na2CO3 form, which is available only 0.5%. So students, which one you want to purify? Which one you want to purify? This one or this one? Obviously this one, because when you purify this salt, you get the 90% of sodium here. So this is profitable. When you purify this one, you got only the 0.5% of sodium. So this is profitable because in this salt, the 90% of salt metal is present here. So that is profitable. Called as the profitable extraction of metal called as a ore. Right? Mineral from which metal extracted conveniently and profitably. Profitable means high percentage. Right, high percentage, the mineral from which metals are present very high percentage called as ore. Understood, students? So look at here, I will give few more example. So one more important point, all ores are minerals, but minerals are not ore. Right? So look at here, the many ores are present here, many number of ores present here, but this all the ores not be a minerals. All the ores are minerals. This all the ores are minerals, but all the minerals are not a ore. So here in the sodium, this sodium here it available, sodium available here 80%, here available the 10%, and here in this form it available 0.5% here, 0.2%. So tell me, students, which one you want to purify? First one, second one, third one, fourth one. Obviously first one you want to purify, because when you purify this one, you got 80% of sodium, so that is, it is more profitable. So this is we called as a ore, but these three are, we cannot be called as ore, because here less percentage of sodium is present, so it is not a ore. This is ore. Reference. Similarly, aluminium, bauxite, corundum, feldspar, creolite, aluminate, and kaolin. So here the ore is available at 70%. Second one, 10%. Third one, 5%. And here it available the 0.2%, and this is 0.1%. So which one you want to purify, students? First one. So that's why the bauxite is be called as a ore, and remainings we cannot be called as ore because it is not profitable, and this is a profitable because 70%. I hope you understood, friends. So extraction of metal. To obtain the metal from metal ore, to obtain the metal from ore called as extraction of metal. So various processes are involved to extraction of the metals from their ore and refining, known as a metallurgy. So process of separation of the metal from ore, this process we called as metallurgy, right? So major steps involved in the extraction of metal: concentration of ore, conversion of metal, conversion of concentrated ore into metal, refining impure metal, right? First one, concentration of ore. Ore is the impure compound of metal. Ore contain impurities like sand, rock, earth particle, limestone, etc., called as gangue. The ore which contain the, what is the ore? For example, when you find the 5 rupees coin in the earth crust, right, while the digging the earth, you got the 5 rupees coin. So tell me, if this 5 rupees coin is pure form, is this 5 rupees coin is glittering? No, because this 5 rupees coins are surrounded by the sand, mud, and the some other limestone particles are surrounded, right? So here surrounded, the sand, mud, limestone particles surrounded, so it is impure. So such type of impure we called as a gangue. Right, students? We called as gangue. Understood? So removal of unwanted impurity, that is gangue. Gangue washed with water to get concentrated ore. Gangue ore washed with water to get the concentrated ore. Right, students? So second method, conversion of concentrated ore into metal. So here the 3 steps are present here. Concentrated ore into metal. First one, the concentrated metals are classified based on the reactivity: metal high reactive, metal moderate reactive, metal low reactive. Right, students? So potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium are the high reactive. Carbon, zinc, iron, tin, lead, copper are the moderate reactive. Silver, gold, platinum are the low reactive. Right, students? So these elements are purified, considered as a high reactive. These elements are the low reactive, and these elements are the low reactive. Right, students? So extraction of high reactive metal: sodium, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium are the high reactive elements. They are purified by the electrolysis. So metals such as sodium, potassium, calcium, etc., high reactive metal cannot be reduced by carbon because the metals have a high affinity with water or high attraction with water. Therefore, carbon unable to separate them. So students, so what are the high reactive elements are there, like the K2O, right? So K2O cannot be purified with the carbon because the oxygen and potassium are strongly bond with each other. So that's why the carbon is unable to separate them, so we can't be reduced with carbon. Reduce means the removal of oxygen. We can't be remove the oxygens from potassium because a strong attraction is present between the oxygen and potassiums. Reference. So high reactive metal separated by the electrolysis method. That's why we are using electrolysis here. So in this beaker, look at here, students. I am using the molten NaCl. Molten means the NaCl are heated, it turns into NaCl liquid form, but here NaCl in solid form. Solid NaCl heated turns into liquid NaCl. Right, students? So NaCl, if we dip the 2 electrode anode cathode connected with battery, then what happens, students? NaCl dissociated to form sodium ion and chloride ion. Sodium is positive charge, chloride is negative charge. Right. So sodium positive charge attracted to the cathode, chloride negative charge attracted to the anode. So in this method, we have to separate the sodium and chloride or any other metals. Right. And metal medium reactive. So medium reactive metals are purified by the calcination and roasting process. Calcination means metal ore heated in absence of air, called as calcination. Metal is heated in absence of air, called as a calcination. So calcination process used for conversion of metal carbonate. It is important point, friends. It is very important point. It is used for conversion of metal carbonate into metal oxide. Metal oxide. Look at here. Metal carbonate turns into metal oxide. Again, second step, metal oxide turns into metal. So here it is completely pure. It means in these two steps, step 1, step 2, here applied zinc, separated from zinc, obtained from zinc carbonate. Right. Look at here. Zinc carbonate heated in absence of air turns into zinc, turns into zinc oxide. Right. This zinc oxide again, this only zinc oxide are again heated, it turns into zinc, that is the pure form. Right? Understood, students? So next, roasting. Metal ore heated in presence of air, called as roastings. Metal ore are heated in presence of air, students, called as roasting. Roasting process used for conversion of metal sulfide ore to metal oxide. Right. For example, zinc sulfide, look at here, sulfide is present. If metal is bonded with the sulfide, so such type of metals are purified by the roasting. Right. If metal is bonded with the carbonate CO3, such type of metals are separated by the calcination. So friends, zinc sulfide turns into zinc oxide. Again, this zinc oxide are treated with carbon. Carbon reacts with the oxygen to form carbon dioxide, and pure zinc is separated. This is pure zinc. Right, friends? So third step, extraction of less reactive metal. Less reactive metal, mercury, copper extracted, reduction of their oxide by heat alone. Right, students, just we are applying the heat to the purifying the less reactive metals. Purifying less reactive metals. Right, students? Okay. The next is a refining process. The thick block impure metal kept at anode and pure metal at the cathode. Both impure metal and pure metals are immersed into beaker containing salt solution. On passing electric current, impure metal dissolved from anode and goes to the electrolytic solution and then attract to cathode. Insoluble impure anode settled down, impurities are settled down. Look at here the example, students. Here cathode and anode is positive charge, cathode is negative charge. Here we kept the impure mud is present here. Right, mud is present. So what happened here, students? We are using the copper here. So when we supply the electric current, the copper enter into the solution as a copper ion. Copper ion positive charge, it get attracted to the negative charge cathode. These all are attracted to the cathode. all the cathodes are moved towards the sorry all the copper moved towards the cathode, then what happens students? The mud is settled down here, mud is impurity settled down. Right students, I hope you understood that this is a two-way topic students. If you have find any doubt, ask me students. Thank you so much.